Hey, what's up guys? So welcome back to another video, and this is the Jasminer X41U. As you can see, it fits perfectly nice in a 19-inch server rack, and it's only 1AG or 1U, and this thing has up to 600 mega hashes per second, so really powerful, and the power consumption is only roundabout, from my tests, 290 watts. So this is an Ethereum ASIC, but it can also mine much more other coins. All right, so the Jasminer X41U, I've got it from Jinglemining.com. You can find the link down below in the description. So they are the official retailer, very trustworthy, and many people asked about it. Where do you get it? You can find it down below. So as I've told you before, 1U, very compact size. It has built-in fans, built-in power supply, and the only thing you need to do is connect it to Ethernet, so to get some internet connection, and connect it to power. The setup is very simple, I will show you later, but let's talk about the other key facts about this miner. Now, you probably know about GPU mining. The benefit of GPU mining is that you can mine all kinds of coins, it doesn't depend on the algorithm. Now, this ASIC has the ETC hash algorithm and the ET hash algorithm. That means you can mine Ethereum, you can mine Ethereum Classic, and some various other coins that are based on those algorithms. But why is it so efficient? Well, 600 mega hashes per second, especially at a power consumption of 290 watts, is really crazy. If you're looking at that on GPUs, well, you also spend a lot of money on GPUs, probably with an even much higher power consumption. Now, there are 8 high-efficient ASIC chips inside. Each of them is capable of a processing power of 65 mega hashes per second with a memory access bandwidth of 1 terabyte per second. So this is how you can achieve those up to 600 mega hashes per second in the overclocking mode. Now let's have a closer look at the ASIC itself. So it comes in this form factor, you can rack mount it. I also tried it in my server rig, that's perfectly fine. You have here the holes for the screws to keep it in place. Now I didn't see any mounts for rails, but you can put it basically on a floor in the rack. Then there are several LEDs on the miner. We have a reset LED, we have the normal operating LED and the fault LED. When you set it up for the first time, don't be scared. Default LED will be in red because this means there is no pool configured. I'll show you later how to put in the pool. It's very simple. And last but not least, there's a little button. It's actually the only button on this miner, which is the IP report. So just imagine you have multiple of those miners in your home, in your server rig, or wherever you are going to mine, and it's sometimes difficult to find out the IP address. With that button, it's basically really simple. There's a software, an IP monitoring software. You just load it up, you press the IP report button, and it will show up on your computer and you can start configuring it. So on the back of the miner, there is actually an SD card slot. Now, I'm not 100% sure why you need it. I think maybe for some firmware upgrades, but you can do the firmware upgrades over the software interface. You have an Ethernet port right over here for the internet connection. So there's no Wi-Fi on this thing, but you can use, for instance, a Wi-Fi extender and just go out from there with Ethernet to the miners. And also there's the power plug. So two things you have to connect, and then you can actually start mining. Now, there are a bunch of fans inside there. As you can see right over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they are in lines here in the front, in the back, so to have proper cooling of the ASIC, and they spin up with up to 12,000 RPMs. Now, it's not so noisy like Bitcoin ASICs. So the Bitcoin ASICs I was running at home, for instance, the Antminers, they are much louder because they have big fans spinning at those RPMs, but still you will hear the noise definitely, so I keep it in my basement, and they're pretty good because it's cool and the miner stays between 30 and 40 degrees, which is really perfect condition. Now the configuration of the ASIC is really simple. There's an IP management tool, so you can easily find the IP address of your miner or miners, and then you can simply log in into the browser interface and do the whole setup. I will now show you on the computer how it works, so let's go. Alright, so the setup of your miner is pretty simple. There's the IP finder tool, it's called SLMiner, and here you can easily configure and set up your miner. Once you have connected it to your network, you probably don't know the IP address, but you can easily find it right over here. So here you see the IP range of my network, and if we go here to the management, I can press just start monitoring, and it will find the miner here in the list. there's an IP report button on the miner itself. So when you start the monitoring, you need to click the button on the miner and then it will actually show up the IP address, the MAC address, and then you can already start to configure it. Now the tool itself also has various other things, like you can see the miner right over here, you can see to which pool it is connected, you can see the address of your wallet it's mining to, you can see the hash rate. So currently, as you can see, the real-time hash rate is 600, so the average over 24 hours is 566 in the overclocking mode, which is really crazy, especially if you keep in mind it's draining only around about 290 watts from the power socket. We can also see the temperature of the miner, which is right now at 33 to 48 degrees, so that's pretty good, but the fans are also spinning quite high, so we have 12,000 RPMs on the fans, which is kind of noisy. Now, you can also do firmware upgrades, so you just go to the file selection and then you can upgrade it here. You can test the LEDs, you can restart the miner, all from that tool. So it's very, very simple to manage the miners, especially if you have more miners. You just put the IP address as a sticker on the miners and you can easily configure everything in the tool. Then there is the browser interface. So let's check this out. All right, once you know the IP address of your miner, you just put it into the browser and then you are in this user interface. If you need to log in, the basic is root. Then here you can see I'm the miner. So as you can see, Jasminer X4 server, you can see the IP address, the DNS and everything. Then here we have the status. As you can see, its uptime is now 2 days. I had a little reset before. So the average hash rate is around 567, really good, really low reject rate. It's currently connected to Ethermine, to mine. So as you can see, works accepted, very low rejected. And hash rate and temperature and the ASIC status, I'm not really sure what this means, but I think how good the ASIC still is, if there are any issues, it will probably go down. Anyhow, you can monitor the fan speeds here as well. Then here we have the settings for the miner. So we have here the pool URL and the work and my wallet and basically password. So you can set up to 3 pools. And here it's really important. You can select the coin you want to mine. So we have here Ethereum and ETC, currently mining Ethereum. And there's a frequency select. So there's 200 megahertz, or there is the boost overclocking mode of 225 megahertz, which gives you this amazing hash rate, which I'm achieving right now. Then here we have the network settings. I'm currently running it on DHCP, but you can also change it to static if you want to. You can set an admin password for every individual miner. You can see the log right over here. So if there is anything going on, you can check it here in the log file. You can do the firmware upgrades directly over the interface right over here. And last but not least, if you have any issues with the miner, reboot, or you can completely reset the miner. So very simple. I still remember Bitcoin mining where you had to set up a Raspberry Pi, everything super complicated. But really, this was the most easy and straightforward ASIC setup I've ever done. So let's check it out on the pool, really important, so you can see how it is evolving. I'm running it for round about 2 weeks. I mined round about 0.15 Ethereum. So right now with this hash rate, I think it's up to 0.3 a month. So this is actually quite good. Also here, the average hash rate is the same on the pool like on the miner. So you can see there is no fake of cloud mining. So you can see it's absolutely not fake. So it's really achieving the 561 mega hashes per second, which is absolutely crazy. All right, so basically that's the whole software. As you can see, really straightforward. I did set it up and 2 weeks, I basically didn't touch it. It was running through. And if you want to, I also have it on my phone. So to monitor, you can also check it out on Ethermine. And yeah, the monitoring is really easy. All right, guys, so the Ethereum miner right now is in my basement. Right now, the miner is in the overclocking mode. The power consumption is very low. It's very efficient. We have a really nice hash rate of almost 600 mega hashes per second at only 290 watts. So this is the most efficient Ethereum ASIC I've ever seen. It's absolutely crazy. And also regarding the temperatures, now you definitely feel it's sucking air in from here, throwing it out at the back. And the temperatures here on the case, as you can see, it's just ambient temperature. So it doesn't really get warm. 290 watts, well, that's not a lot of power to dissipate in that huge case. And also the temperature is really fine. Now I have it running for 2 weeks almost, and there was not a single shutdown. Also regarding the internet connection, you need to have a kind of stable internet connection, but it doesn't need to be fast. We're here in my basement, we have here a Wi-Fi extender, which is extending the Wi-Fi, so it's not very good internet, but I don't have any problem mining. So even if you have this in a remote location and for instance you connect a UMTS modem, you're perfectly fine. Alright guys, so that's basically it. As you can see, just connected to power, it has Wi-Fi right over here, which basically has an Ethernet out which is connected to the machine, and it's running pretty fine here in my basement. Alright guys, so that's the Jasminer X4 1U. I didn't believe it myself that it has this power at this power consumption. So that's very, very efficient. Not sure how long they have been running in China already, but still, right now you can also get them, and from Jinglemining, links are down below. So currently it's retailing for around about $8,000, so they are not really cheap, but also they mine quite a lot of Ethereum right now. Now, is this thing worth it to get it for home use or to buy many of them to run in your server farm? Well, you have to think about that. Now, Ethereum will at some point be proof of stake. That means you cannot mine it anymore. And when that happens, basically, you can only mine other coins. Now, the Jasminer X4 1U supports also the ETC hash algorithm. So you can mine, for instance, Ethereum Classic. Also, you can mine some other coins supported like ETC, ETP, EXP. So you can find the whole list of coins down below. So I guess you would have to switch to Ethereum Classic. Personally, I'm really not a fan of Ethereum Classic, but this could be something where you can actually continue mining to get your return on investment. And also this miner has 5 GB of DAG file size, so once Ethereum gets over those 5 GB, you cannot mine it anymore, but Ethereum Classic, you can mine many more years with that. And depending on how this is going to evolve, you will get your return on investment sooner or later. So this really depends, and I think from this point of view right now, no one can tell you how fast you will get your return on investment. But personally, I think it's a great miner because with 290 watts, you're not overloading, for instance, your home power network, because also if you have a big Bitcoin ASIC at home, at some point, if you drain so much power, you have to pay a lot of money to the electricity provider because you get over some certain limits. And this is really something you can run at home. And if you run it for a couple of years longer with Ethereum Classic or some other coins based on this algorithm, it's actually, I think, a good choice. Alright guys, so if you want to have some more information, links are down below to Jinglemining, so make sure to check it out. I was very interested in this thing because I didn't believe that it's so efficient compared to GPUs, but well, it's an ASIC of course. GPUs are also quite expensive, so keep this in mind. Maybe it sounds a bit high right now, but if you want to have this power in GPUs, you spend a lot of coin. Alright guys, so big thanks for watching. As always guys, if you have any questions, write them down below in the comments, and I'm Steven from Tech Magnet, and I'm signing out. Bye.